Good evening, dear ladies. בסייעתא דשמיא, I would like to bless all of us, שיתגלה משיח צדקנו במהרה בימינו, אמן. May Hashem reveal him. ושיגיע המבשר, the messenger, אליהו הנביא, אליהו התשבי, אליהו גלעדי, במהרה משיח ודוד, אליהו הנביא זכור לטוב. Today the lesson is for רפואה שלמה. בסייעתא דשמיא, של דוד חי בן מפרת. של בסייעתא דשמיא, מלכה בת מרוסיה, אמא שלום. רפואה שלמה של דוד בן איריס עדינה בעזרת השם. רפואה שלמה לכלל עמו ישראל וללאה חיה בת שרה וליעקב בן מלכה ויעקב משיח בן נעמי ולכלל עמו ישראל בעזרת השם. אמן. I would like to remind you this Shabbat is Shabbat Chazon. Shabbat, this coming Shabbat is Tisha B'Av. It's the 9th of Av already, but it's Shabbat, so on Shabbat we don't fast. The fast is postponed to Sunday. We are going to speak about the Jewish laws of Tisha B'Av, of the 9th of Av, B'Siyata D'Shmei, after I finish this part of the lesson. So I would like to remind you...
So we're not reading Tehillim, right?
Yeah, we read Tehillim, and now we're going to speak about something in this shul. I would like to tell you Shabbat Chazon is called Shabbat Chazon because this is the Haftarah that comes from Yishayahu, Anabi Chazon Yishayahu. Dear ladies, this is the first chapter you'll see, the Chazon Yishayahu ben Amoz. This is part of all of the prophecies that tell us about the ruining of the temple. So it's because the Haftarah is Chazon Yishayahu ben Amoz, the Shabbat is called Shabbat Chazon. And I would like to remind you that there's, Hashem gave me the zchut to give you this Shabbat, we're opening Chumash Dvarim. And Hashem gave you the zchut to give you a few lessons about Parashat Dvarim, the portion of Dvarim. So please go to rabbanitirs.com or toranytime.com and you'll see over there Parashat Dvarim b'siyata d'shmeh that Hashem gave me to give you. Today we're going to speak about something else. We'll start by connecting what I'm going to speak now to the 3 weeks. בין המצרים. It's written in Megillat Eicha, which we're going to read for Motzei Shabbat. When Shabbat goes out, we're going to read Eicha. It's written, Kol Rodfei Yisigu Ben Hametzarim. Which means, all the people that, literally what it means, that were chasing her, the children of Israel, they seized her, Ben Hametzarim, among the borders. But truly it means that Kol Rodfei, he who runs and seeks from to know Hashem and to know the truth, he wants to know the truth about Hashem. You know, we have wills. Hashem wants us to do something, he tells us his way. But like somebody, a woman came to me and I blessed her that she will do tshuva, and she said, no, my daughter is a Hasidish, but I'm okay like I am. And I said to myself, this is not your will. This is the will of the evil inclinations. This is the will of Yetzer Hara. It's not your will. Your will is to do the will of Hashem. But the Yetzer Hara comes to us and disguises himself in things that we think that it's hard for us with imagination. So our will is to do exactly what Hashem wants us to do. But Yetzer Hara doesn't want us to do exactly what Hashem wants us to do. Hashem says, you have suffering, you want to that it will stop, take a mitzvah on yourself. Do something, take a mitzvah. If you're not snoot, be snoot. If you don't cover your head, cover your head. Say, Hashem, b'siyata d'shmaya, I'm accepting upon myself this and this mitzvah. And because of this, for this refuah shlema, for marriages, for children, it doesn't matter what you want. For everything that you need. Once you accept upon yourself a mitzvah, once you said it from your mouth, there's a big angel that's created from your words. And now the angel is over there to protect you. So if we have suffering, the first thing that we should do is accept a mitzvah upon ourselves. Something that is hard for us to do, to accept, even if we do that for another person. And then we have big miracles. And then we say to Hashem, Hashem, b'siyata d'shmaya, when this and this happens, b'siyata d'shmaya, I'm going to do sudat mitzvah, a meal of mitzvah, and I'm going to praise your name, Hashem, and in front of all the people that I'm inviting, and there has to be at least 10 men also over there that will say, and a few that will say Dvar Torah, and I will go, and I'll say Nishmat Kol Chai, which we have on Shabbat, the Nishmat Kol Chai, dear ladies, after Shirat Hayam, and over there I will say in front of all of them to praise your name and to say thank you for the miracle that you did for me. You understand? Once you say this to Hashem before everything happens, Before you say that, you accept upon yourself, bli neder be'ezrat Hashem, to do it, Hashem helps, because you create an angel to help you. Spiritually, there's an angel that stands on your right side and helps you. So, when we say, kol rotfia, he who seeks Hashem, when Hashem's name is only half, because you remember, ki yad al kasiya milchama la'Hashem ba'amalek, Hashem said, until Amalek is eliminated from this world, my name is only half. It's not yud kei vav kei, it's only yud kei. You see? Kol rotfia, he who seeks Hashem. And this is half of the name of Hashem. Sigua, he's going to find and complete the name of Hashem. You see, Sigua. Hashem will give him the zchut. Together, it's Yud Kei Vav Kei. You see it? Together, it's Yud Kei Vav Kei, which means he who seeks to find the truth of Hashem, when the name of Hashem is only half, gets the merit to complete the name of Hashem. Ben HaMeitzarim, even a time that Hashem is hidden from us, that we do not see it like the children of Israel used to saw the Shekhinah, the divine presence, when they went out of Egypt and the sea was split for them. So even then, dear ladies, we can see over here that even when Hashem is hiding himself, we can see if truly we are seeking the truth, Hashem will help us find the truth. And by seeking it, by wanting to know truly Hashem, knowing by our hearts, it's not enough to know by our brains and to say it by our mouth. We need to feel it in our hearts. To know means to feel it in our heart, to know that this is true. So even though at these times there's Hester Panim, that Hashem is hiding from us, everything is God, and God is everything. I cannot stand over here and speak without the power of God, because the soul that He gave me, it's His power. So the soul is the one that is lifting the body. The soul is the one that is speaking, looking, listening, hearing, smelling. Everything moves the hands. It's the soul. When the soul goes out, the body is lifeless. There's no life in this, in the body. So everything is about the soul. Even when a person, you remember, there's a story about the Baal Shem Tov that came to a very sick person. All the doctors says it's this sickness, he cannot go out of it. And they told him he has only a few hours. And the Baal Shem Tov said to the doctor, please go out, let me speak with the person. And this person couldn't speak. And Baal Shem Tov spoke with him, and he called the doctor to come in. A few minutes after that, the person was sitting in his bed. So the doctor said, what's this? How come? I know that it couldn't be, it can't be. This is above nature. So he said, you spoke to his body, but I spoke to his soul. Mm-hmm. And I told him, if you do tshuva, if you accept upon yourself tshuva, b'siyata dishmei Hashem will give you life. So dear ladies, only tshuva saves us. So we need to accept upon ourselves the way of Hashem and mitzvot of Hashem. Even if we do this for another person, when we do something for another person, listen very carefully. If chas v'shalom, something is going to happen to us, the angels in heaven tell Hashem, Hashem, but your daughter did something, took a mitzvah, a kisui rosh, covering her head, or tzniut, or any mitzvah, took upon herself for this man, you have to find mercy for her. Do you understand? So even if we do it for somebody else. Now, ben ha-meitzarim, dear ladies, this is a meitzarim. In between the borders, these are the 3 weeks, 21 days. But when I write a meitzarim, it's also mitzrayim. Yeah. You see? It's also mitzrayim. Ben ha-meitzarim is also, this is meitzarim, it's also mitzrayim. And what we see in the middle of mitzrayim, Egypt, we have Tzadik Resh Yud, which is Yetzer. This is the Yetzer, evil inclination over here. And we have a Mem that is open and the Mem that is closed. You see over here? The exile of Egypt included all of the exiles that were supposed to come until Mashiach. We know that, but the last parasha that we read in Chumash Bamidbar, it's written, Ele Masa'ei Bnei Yisrael, Ele Masa'ei Bnei Yisrael, which means these are the journeys of the children of Israel after they went out of Egypt. So, we have the initials of each word stands for all of the exile that the children of Israel will have. Ele starts with an Aleph. Aleph is Edom, which is this exile, the exile of Rome after the ruining of the Second Temple. Masae starts with the letter Mem, which is Madai veParas. You remember Haman HaRasha? This is the exile of Madai veParas. Then Bet is Babel. Babel is Iraq, the first ruining of the temple, the first temple, dear ladies, Babel. And the third one is Yavan, Greece. Wow. All of the four exiles we can see, they're included in Mitzrayim. All of them. Why? Because until today, we are in two exiles, and it doesn't matter where we are. We can be in the same exile even if we are in the land of Israel. One is Galut Hadat. Galut Hadat. The exile of knowing Hashem, which we do not know Hashem. We think everything is nature. And we trust things that we see. We don't trust our chushim, our senses. We trust everything that we see. If we see, Baruch Hashem, dear ladies, then we believe. If we don't see, there's a question about believing or not. We don't trust the senses that we have, the third sense that we have that comes directly from Hashem. And then there's Galut HaDibur, the exile of speech, which means instead of using our mouth for holiness, for all the laws of Hashem, and for only the livelihood of the body, Chas V'Shalom, we can use our mouth to slander, to curse, to do things that are not good, Lashon Hara, dear ladies. And these are two galuyot that it's until Mashiach comes, B'siyata D'Shmaya, we are still in those galuyot. How do we see it through Egypt? Why is it Egypt is exile of Egypt includes everything? Because it starts with an open mem and ends with a closed mem. In the middle we have the evil inclination, Yetzer Hara. The open mem is the action, maaseh. The action that the person does. And the closed mem is the thoughts, machshava. Is the thought of a person. Closed mean our thoughts, nobody knows them. It's closed. Who knows our thoughts? Only Hashem. Hashem is the only one that can read our thoughts and speak to us through our thoughts. But nobody else can, even angels cannot do that. And the mem that is open, the action is revealed to everybody. Everybody sees. If we give tzedakah, if we do something not good, everybody sees us. It's galui. This is hidden. The thought is hidden. The action is revealed. Everybody sees. The evil inclination wants to separate the action from the thought. Why? Because if you remember, we had lessons about it, the soul is separated to five main parts. There's Chayav Yechida that is under the throne of Hashem, and then, dear ladies, there's the Neshama that is in the mind. Okay, this is the place of the Neshama. There's the Ruach, this part of Neshama that is lower than the Neshama, which is in our heart. And there's the nefesh, which is the lowest part, and it flows through our bloodstream. This is the nefesh. So if the neshama that is in the mind wants to do everything that Hashem wants us to do, the nefesh, which is in the blood, wants all of the joy of this world. Eat, drink, dance, do everything, everything that is in this world. This is the nefesh. The heart, which the ruach is in the heart, this part of the neshama that is called the ruach, over there, it's the battery. The heart, by its desires, decides either to listen to the neshama, which is in the mind, to listen to Hashem, or to listen to the nefesh that wants all of the desires in this world. So the evil inclination wants to separate the action from the thought, because the action comes from the blood, the heart and the blood, and it doesn't want us to listen to Hashem. So, how do we close the mouth of the mem? The Torah, the oral Torah starts with mem, Matai Korin Shma Shel Arvit. When do we read Shma Be'arvit? It's considered to the when a boy becomes old enough in order to start Kriyat Shma v'chulei, it's bar mitzvah. So mem Matai, dear ladies, starts with a mem that is open. But the Mishnah ends with Hashem Oz La'amo Yiten Hashem Yevarech Et Amo Bashalom, with a mem that is closed. The oral Torah starts with a mem that is open and ends with a mem that is closed. Why? In order to close the mouth of the evil inclination. Once we study the Torah, we become really with a freedom of choice. Why? Because we close the mouth of the evil inclination. Because we understand that this is only imagination, and what Hashem wants, that God wants, this is the truth in life. We are only visitors over here. Very temporary. Nobody knows when they go out. If you came to this world, you know you go out. You just don't know when. Nobody knows.
Yeah.
So we should follow the way of Hashem and do exactly what Hashem wants us. And don't say, tomorrow I'll do tshuva. My friends didn't tomorrow. There's no time to do tshuva because nobody knows when Hashem knocks on the door. It's either now or never. So it's now for us. Every day has a reality of itself. Every day is like a page in a book, a true reality on its own, existence on its own, every day. Why? Because every day when you wake up, you don't daven the same way that you don't pray the same way that you prayed a day before. Sometimes you daven the whole, you pray the whole prayer. Sometimes you do half of it. Sometimes you don't have time. You postpone the Tehillim to the next day or to the night after midnight. So every day has its own existence. Ve'Avraham zaken ba be'yamim, and Abraham was old and he came with the days. It means he came with a book, and every day was a page in the book that he went in the ways of Hashem. Now, dear ladies, it was 2 yahrzeit. I'm going to connect it to what I'm going to speak now. There were 2 yahrzeits now. Today was the yahrzeit of the Arizal, Zchutot Hagen Aleinu. And 2 days ago, it was the yahrzeit of Rabbi Shimshon Maastropolia, Zchutot Hagen Aleinu, which is a big mekubal. We are going to learn something together. I know it's not easy. You should come close to me and pay attention to what we're going to do on the board. This what you see over here, and I'm going to read it to you and explain it to it in English, Bezrat Hashem, and then we'll go into it and study it. This is what the Arizal said about the Egyptians, what happened to the Egyptians in Egypt, and what happened to the children of Israel. But what's written over here is in a code. It's very hard to understand. So I'm going, there's a big mitzvah, a big zchut, before Pesach, at the eve of Pesach, to read about Korban Pesach, the sacrifice of Pesach, and then to read Igeret Rabbi Shimshon Maastropolia. We lit a candles over there for them. To read the Igeret, the note that wrote Rabbi Shimshon Maastropolia, explaining what the Arizal wrote. And it says like this, dear ladies. That's why I'm telling you, it's very special that you came today. It's written, listen very carefully. Let's start from the beginning first. Elokeinu ve'elokei avoteinu, melech rachman, rachem alen, which means, Hashem, please have mercy upon us. Tovu meitivi derech lanu, please give us only good things. Shuva elenu ba'amon rachamecha, please bring the divine presence back to us. Biglal avot she'asu retzonecha, in the sake of our forefathers that did your will. Bnei beitcha kevatchila, build your temple like at the beginning. Vekonen bet mikdashecha al mechonon, put him in Yerushalayim in his place. Va'arenu bevinyano, that we'll have the zchut to see him. Ve'samchenu betikono, and we'll be happy when we'll see him. Va'ashev shchinatcha letrocho, and bring your divine presence, the shchina inside the Beit HaMikdash, inside the temple. Ve'ashev kohanim la'avodatam, and bring the kohanim back to their worship in the temple. Ve'lalevim leshiram ulezimram, and the Levites to sing inside the temple. Ve'ashev Yisrael in them, and bring all klal Yisrael to the land of Israel. Ve'sham na'ale v'ne'ra'e v'nishtachave lefanecha b'shalosh pa'amei ragleinu. And over there we'll come to you on the 3 high holidays, which is Pesach, Shavuot, Besukot, Besiyata Dishmaya, and v'nochal shemin hazbachim u'min hapsachim, and that we can eat from the sacrifices over there, and the sacrifice of Pesach. And asher yagi adamam al kir mizbarecha l'ratzon, and you will get the sacrifice and the blood of the sacrifice in a good will. Ve'yu l'ratzon imrei pinu v'gondibenu lefanecha Hashem tzurenu v'goalenu. Now it's written, סגולה גדולה ונפלאה. It's a big סגולה. ללמוד בערב פסח, to study on the eve of Pesach, and every day of the year. Listen very carefully, it says, כל המעיין בסוד הנפלא הזה, he who learns this secret thing, this beautiful secret thing, על מכונו, אפילו פעם אחת בשנה, even once a year, and especially on the eve of Pesach, and you can do it the whole year, once a year, מובטח לו שינצל באותה שנה, it's promised to him, this is what Rabbi Shimshon Maestropoli says, זכותות הגן עלינו, it's your, his yours it was on the 3rd of Av, it's promised to him that he will be saved that year, מכל מכשול ומיטה משונה, from anything bad and any a death, לא עלינו. ושום אדם לא ימשול בו, and no human being can control him. וכל אויביו יפלו לפניו, and all of his enemies are going to fall in front of him. והוא על במותינו ידרוך, and he will, לדרוך עליהם. He will step on them, בסייעתא דשמיא. וכל אשר יפנה יצליח, and everything that he will do, he will have success. ובכל עסקיו ירוויח, and he will have a profit from all of his businesses. Ad biyat ha-goel, amen, selah.
Amen.
So it's a big time that you came to this lesson. Now, dear ladies, I'm going to read for you, b'siyata dishmaya, what the Arizal wrote, and then we're going to speak about how Rabbi Shimshon Maestropoli, it's a big zchut to be in this shiur. And b'siyata dishmaya, may Klal Yisrael will have the zchut that we are studying this now, b'siyata dishmaya.
Amen.
So, dear ladies, it starts. Hine kvar hodaticha, hine kvar hodaticha shepa'on nilka b'mitzrayim b'esr makot. Arizal says, I already told you that in Egypt, פרעה had 10 plagues. על ידי 3,280 מלאכי חבלה, פרעה had upon him 10 plagues by, he says, Arizal, by 3,280 angels of destruction. And then he says, המסבבים בשלושה רקיעים, and they are in 3 levels of heaven. בשלושה רקיעים של טומאה, and these 3 levels are the levels in Gehinnom, in hell, dear ladies, 3 levels over there, that these 3,280 angels of destruction. And what do they do there? So it says that these angels cause lo aleinu suffering to people in hell in 3 levels over there, and because in order to cleanse them, that they can go into paradise after that. But first they go through a lot of suffering in hell, in 3 levels in hell. And then it says, Ha'echad nikra, so one of the levels is called, this is its name, I don't want to say now the letters, I will say it later, this is his name. V'ashani nikra, this is the name of the second one. V'ashlishi nikra, this is the third. ועליהם השר נקרא, and there's a minister, an angel that is above those 3,280 angels, that this is his name. ועל כולם, and above him, there's another angel that this is his name. And then he says, בראשית והנה חסר מן השלישי עשרה, and then at the beginning, he says, from the third one, 10 is missing, וחסר מן הרביעי שישה, and the fourth one, 6 is missing, וחסר מן התשיעי שישה, and from the ninth one, 6 is missing, ככתוב בתורה, like it's written in the Torah. So this is half of the riddle of the Arizal, and we're going to, by Rabbi Shimshon Maestropoli, בסייעתא דשמיא, to reveal this. This is a big zchut, because like I told you a minute ago, he who studies this even once a year, is saved from death, saved from everything, dear ladies, everything bad, Amen. And he has all success, Bezrat Hashem.
Amen.
So please pay attention, we're going to do it together. So Rabbi Shimshon Maestropoli says, there's a siman, there's a sign for these 3,280 destructive angels. And it comes from Yoshua the prophet, and it says, La'akot begrof rasha, which means to hit with a fist a wicked person. La'akot begrof. It says the siman, the sign is egrof. dear ladies, a growth. You know, and at the beginning I was thinking, how is this the sign? I was sitting in my, thinking to myself, how is this the sign? And you know, Hashem gave me just a light. So look at the Egrof. Egrof is a fist. Aleph, this is the letter Aleph. But if I put different Nikud after Aleph, it becomes Aleph, 1,000. The same letters, Aleph, Aleph, it's the same letters, but with the dots, different dots, as this is 1,000. Gimel in numerical value is 3. 3 multiplied by 1,000 is 3,000. Reish is 200, and Pei is 80. So it's 3,280 destructive angels. That's why that, wait, it's incredible. It's a schut to be in this shul. It's far for you. Please come sit over here. Please. Please come. Tell you, everybody come close. So a gold fist is a sign for these destructive angels. Why? Because Aleph is Aleph. It's 1,000. Gimel is 3. If you multiply it by 1,000, it's 3,000. Reish is 200 in numerical value. And Pei is 80. You add 3,200 and then plus 80, it's 3,280 destructive angels. Now, dear ladies, let's see how truly they all came. I told you everything starts and ends with letters. So please, I want to show you something. So let's go through all of the 10 plagues, okay? It's Dam, Tzfardea, Kinim. Arov. Arov, Dever, Shechin, Shechin, Barad, Arbe, Choshech, and then we have Bechorot. Arov, Dever, okay. We have the 10 plagues. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, okay. So these are the 10 plagues. Blood, frogs, kinim, lice, arov, animals, a shechin, a disease on the skin, barad, the big ice is from hell. Arbe is the grasshoppers, choshech is the darkness, bechorot is the firstborn, okay? Now, I won't do the numerical value each by each one and one, but I already did it at home, I'm gonna give it to you. Dam is 44 in numerical value. Tzfardea is 444. Kinim is 110. Arov is 272. Arov, which means animals. I have to remind myself to say it in English. Okay, and then we have Dever is 206. Shechin, we have 368. Barad is 206. And Arbe is 208. We have Choshech, which is darkness, is 328. And Bechorot is 1,094. If you add all of them, it's 3,280.
That is so cool.
All of them together is the 3,280 destructive angels that Arizal is speaking about. But look, Arizal continues. He says like this. Let's first look over here. Instead of telling you how are the parts in hell called, we'll go after this, and it says, but from the third one, there's 10 missing, and from the fourth one, there's 6 missing, and from the ninth one, there's 6 missing. Dear ladies, look. We see, he says, the third one, 10 missing. So let's make numbers next to the plagues. This is plague number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. He said the third one, 10 is missing. Because kinim, you write with a yud. Yud in numerical value is 10. So from the third one, there's no yud. 10 is missing. He says from the fourth one, 6 is missing. Arov, the animals. From the lice, the yud is missing. Arov, the vav is missing. Vav numerical value is 6. So the fourth one, he says, Vav is 6 is missing. And from the ninth one, he says, 6 is missing. 9 is Choshech. Choshech, there's missing a Vav. Vav is 6 numerical value. So from darkness, there's 6 missing. And he writes, Kakatuv Batorah, because when we open the Agadah, it's not missing. But in the Torah, HaTorah writes it without Yud, without Vav, and without this Vav. That's why the Arizal says, by the Torah, like it's written in the Torah. And when you do the numerical value, it's 3,280 angels of destructions, and the sign is a fist, a gulf. But let's continue. Look how it's beautiful in the schut of them. Look. So it says those three levels. Rakia, איך אומרים רכיה? שכחתי את המילה עכשיו. Rakia, not heaven. There's a name for Rakia. But okay, these three levels of hell, dear ladies, he says one is called, these are the letters, the second one, this is the first one, this is the second one, and this is the third one. So I would like us to look, can I wipe this?
Yes, I go away.
I think you should make copies of this, really, because this is once in a lifetime that people study this like this, B'Siyata D'Shmaya. You should take copies of this. I can wipe the board. Okay, so let's look. Okay, I'll make it over here. I need the colors. If you have colors, use the colors. So, dear ladies, it's written in the Agadah, Eilu Esor Bakot Shevi HaKadosh Baruch Hu LaMitzrim BeMitzrayim. These are the 10 plagues that Hashem brought on the Egyptians in Egypt. So, the first place in hell, this, that the letters are, the first level, which is called, the name is, the letter Shin, and the letter Resh, and the letter Ayin, comes from Eilu Eser, Eser, the word 10. You see, the letters Eser, is the letters of this, you just change the place. You see it? It's Shin, Reish, Ve'ayin. It's the same letters. This is the name of the first Rakia. You see over here, B'shlosha Rakim Shel Tumah. The first Rakia of impurity. It's the word Eser. You see it? It's the same letters. You see it over here? There's Ayin and Ayin, Shin and Shin, and Reish and Reish. This is the first one. The second one, the second Rakia, dear ladies, he said, this is the second Rakia of impurity that the angels come from. So we go, do it, dear ladies, it's the second word, Makot, the plagues. Because you see over here we have Mem, you see Mem and Mem, Mem and Mem, Mem and Mem, I'll write it over here, Makot. And then you have Kacha, Taf. Mem, Vav, Vechav. We have the letter Mem and the letter Mem. We have Chav and Chav. We have Vav and Vav. And we have the Taf. That's the plagues. That's the name of the Rakia, of the second level in hell of impurity. You see? The third one comes Shevi, that Hashem brought. This is the third one. Where is it? Here. Exactly the same letters. Look. Shehevi. I'll write this. You see over here? The letter Shin. Exactly. You see it? Exactly the same letters. The letter Shin. The letter Yud. The letter Bet. The letter Hey. And the letter Aleph. Livriyut. And the letter Aleph. You see it's the same letters. Just they change the place inside the word. This is the name of the third Rakia. And the minister, the angel that is above them, Ba'alehem Asar Nikra, this is his name. So please look. Livriyut. This is the name of the angel. So these are the 10 plagues that Hashem brought on the Egyptians. So Rabbi Shimshon Maastropolis, Chudot Hagan Aleinu, said, look at the word Egyptians. And you should look at the letters that come before the word Egyptians. So what letter comes before Hey? Daled, in the Hebrew Aleph Bet. What letter comes before Mem? Lamed. Lamed. What letter comes before tzaddik? Pei. What letter comes before resh? Kuf. What letter comes before yud? The letter tet. You see, this is the name of the angel that is above all of the 3,280 angels. This is the clue.
Thank you.
Look, dear ladies, this is the angel that is above all these 3,280 angels. And it comes from the word Egyptians, all the letters that come before that. And then, dear ladies, there's an angel that is above all of them, and above this angel, and his name is, he's called letter Taf, and the letter Kuf, and the letter Aleph. Now I want to show you how beautiful, how Hashem loves the children of Israel. I want to show you how beautiful it is. I'm going to wipe the board.
Wait.
Can I wipe the board? Okay, look. In initials, all of the 10 plagues, we write them like this. This is the initials. You see, three plagues together. Dalet, Tzadik Chav, Datzach. And then Adash. You see, Adash. These are the initials. And then, Ken. These are the initials of the 10 plagues. Okay? So let's do the numerical value together. Dalet is 4, Tzadik is 90, Chaf is 20. How much is it together? 114. You should do it quickly. Ayin is 70, Dalet is 4, and Shin is 300. This is 374. Bet is 2, Aleph is 1, Chet is 8, another Bet is 2. How much is it together? 13. How much is it together? 4 plus 4? 8. Plus 3? 1 plus 1 is 2. Plus 1 is 3. Plus 7 is 10. 0 and 1. And then we have 5, which was 1 plus 1 plus 3. It's 501. Okay? 500 in numerical value equals 400 is the letter Taf. 100 is the letter Kuf. 1 equals Aleph. This is the name of the angel, you see it over here, that is responsible for all of these destructive angels. But it's more than that. More than that. Look how beautiful it is. More than that. If I take 501, it also equals Asher. Aleph is 1, Shin is 300, Resh is 200, it's 501. Moshe Rabbeinu asked Hashem, Hashem, when he was standing near the burning bush, and he was asking Hashem, you are sending me to be the Mashiach of the children of Israel, the Messiah for them, but he didn't tell me your name. What shall I, they will ask me, what's your name, Hashem? And he says, Ehyeh Asher Ehyeh. I will be who I'll be. And Ehyeh Asher Ehyeh. I need to wipe the board. Can I wipe this part? Can I wipe the board? We all need miracles from Hashem. Anybody that came to the shiur, it's a big zchut, this shiur. And especially before Tisha B'Av. So, dear ladies, look, I'm writing again. I'm wiping this. I want you to look over here. This is Ehyeh Asher Ehyeh. When we do Netilat Yadayim, we mechaven Ehyeh Asher Ehyeh. Why? Because this is Ehyeh, 21 parts we have over here. Because Ehyeh in numerical value is 21. It's the name of Tshuva of Hashem. And this is 21 parts. This is 21 parts. Asher is over here. Why? Because Asher is Rosh. The letters of Rosh, you see? Head. Asher is the letters of head. So, Ehyeh, Asher, Ehyeh. Ze mamash kacha. Aval, Asher nimtza v'Yisrael. Yisrael. Tistaklu, ze Asher. You see? inside the name of the children of Israel. In the name of the children of Israel, there are the 10 plagues that Hashem brought on our enemies, because this is Asher. You see? Hashem Ires. Ires. Hashem was had a rusin with the children of Israel. Engagement to the children of Israel. You see it over here? Ze Asher. Veze Rosh. The children of Israel are the head of all the nations because they are the firstborn of Hashem. So this Asher, that is a numerical value, all of the 10 plagues, the initials of the 10 plagues, in the name of the children of Israel, when Hashem tells Yaakov Avinu is going to call him Israel, he's preparing already all of the salvation of the children of Israel in Egypt. And all of the salvation from all of the exiles, like I showed you at the beginning, the exile of Babel, the exile of Madai Beparas, the exile of Greek, the exile of Edom, all of the exile, like we showed in the beginning, there's already in the name of the children of Israel. Already, all, not only this, the healing is, comes from this. So let's continue. So now we understand where all of the names come from, and we are over here, this part now. And he says, והנה, והריזל says, זכותות הגן עלינו, והנה מה שמצאינו שלקו המצרים במצרים. And this is what we found, that the Egyptians had לקו, which means they had hits in, in Egypt. 10 מכות על, in Egypt, they had 10 plagues, ועל הים לקו 50 מכות. And on in the ocean, they had 50 plagues on the ocean. מצד השם, this. By this name, these letters of name. But look how beautiful it will be in a minute, you'll understand. Shebo Achuz, and in this name, David Ben Ishai, Mashiach, has a cling to it, to this name, that is the letter Shin, the letter Pei, and the letter Vav. Ve'Hashem Amar, God said, Haku Vikum. God said to this name, hit them, and they were hit. And then, Mitzad Hashem, to the, this second name, Laku HaMitzrim BeMitzrayim, the Egyptians had in Egypt 40 plagues, 40 makot. On the ocean, they had 200 plagues. And Hashem said, hit them to the angels, and they did, the angels hit them. And then it says, and from the, this name, which is the letter Shin, the letter Tzadik, and the letter Hey, Laku HaMitzrim BeMitzrayim, they had 50 plagues from this name, ועל הים לקום 250, and on, in the ocean, they had 250 plagues, dear ladies. והשם אמר, ועיקה. Okay? This is also a riddle. So, Rabbi Shimshon, I didn't tell you something that I'm... I want to tell you, how did Rabbi Shimshon Mastropoli come to all of this? So, he says like this. He says, "V'ineh moray v'rabotai." He says, "My rabbis, kedoshei Israel, the holy people in Israel. Hadvarim eile plaimem. All of this is a riddle. It's above nature. Stumim v'chatumim, not understood, and it's closed. V'ein poresh otam. Nobody knew how to explain this. What the Arizal wrote." וכבר שאלו נגדולי ישראל לברר להם דברי אריזל. And all of the big rabbis asked me to explain to him what the אריזל wrote over here. ולא הגעתי להם, and I did not tell them. ומגודל אהבת מוריי ורבותיי, and because of the love, the unconditional love that I have to my rabbis and to all of the rabbis, אגלה רזה שנתגלה לי בחלום בחזיון לילה. I will reveal this secret that was revealed to me in a dream. In a dream. And this is how he reveals it. So let's go to this. This is beautiful. I'm opening the Agadah Shel Pesach. And in the Agadah, it's written like this. About three Tanaim. In the Haggadah, when we pour the wine and we say the 10 plagues, immediately after that, there are three Tanaim that are mentioned. Rabbi Yosei Aglili, Rabbi Eliezer, and Rabbi Akiva. I'm wiping this bowl because I need it now again. Okay?
This is actually a form of my mother. So this is from him.
Baruch Hashem. It's Me'et Hashem. So dear ladies, I'm writing the names. This is the Tanaim. This is the names of the Tanaim. I'm writing the plagues that they had in Egypt, Mitzrayim, Makot b'Mitzrayim, and Makot al Hayam, and the plagues on the ocean. So we go to Rabbi Yosei Haglili, Rabbi Yosei Haglili. And he says that the Egyptians, it says in the Haggadah, he says that the Egyptians had 10 plagues in Egypt, like we see over here, Esra Makot al Hayam, Esra Makot b'Mitzrayim, and al Hayam, and on the ocean they had 50. See, multiplied by 5 in the ocean. Then Rabbi Eliezer, the Tana, Zchutam Tegen Aleinu, says, we go to the second one. He says, and the Egyptians had 40 makot, 40 plagues in Egypt, and 200 plagues on the ocean, just like it's written, Ba'alayam lakum atay makot. The third one is Rabbi Akiva. Rabbi Akiva says that the plagues that they had in Egypt, he says, B'mitzrayim lakum b'chamishim makot, 50. I want you to see that it's written over here. 50, and on the ocean, 250.
Who's the second rabbi?
Rabbi Eliezer, Atana Rabbi Eliezer, the third one, Rabbi Akiva. Now we're going to go to each one of them. It says about the first one, this is how he refers to them. By the plagues, he refers to them, the Arizal. But the first one, I need the colors so we can see it. The first one, that we have 10 plagues in Egypt and 50 plagues on the ocean, it says, Shebo Achuz David Ben Ishai, that the Mashiach was clinging, he has a clinging to Mashiach Ben David. And let's see. Rabbi Eliezer, Rabbi Yosei Haglili, sorry, Rabbi Yosei Haglili. Rabbi, numerical value, Resh is 200, Bet is 2, Yud is 10, it's 212. Okay? Yosei, it's 86 Yosei, because Yud is 10, Vav is 6, another Yud is 10, and Samech is 60, it's 86. And Haglili, He is 5, Gimel is 3, Lamed is 30, and Yud is 10, so we have 2 Lamed, it's 60, with 2 tens, 60 plus 20 is 80, 88. How much is it together? How much? It's 10. This is 6. And then we have 1, 2. It's 10. 10, 18. And then we have 3. 386. I hope I didn't do it wrong. Yes, 386. 386. What is 386 in numerical value? 300 equals Shin. 80 equals Pei, and 6 equals Vav. Do you see the name? You see the name? Look at the name. This is the name of the Tana, you see, that said that the Egyptians had in Egypt 10 plagues and on the ocean 50. But this Tana is cleansed to Mashiach ben David. It says, the Arizal says, Yesh shebo achiza u'achuz b'David ben Ishai. So let's look at David ben Ishai. David, the son of Ishai. David ben Ishai. David, Dalet is 4, Vav is 6, another Dalet is 4, it's 14. All the Davids, 14. 14 is Yad, it's powerful. Ben, the son, Bet is 2, Nun is 50, together it's 52. Yishai, Yud is 10, Shin is 300, and another Yud is 10. Together it's 320. How much is it together? 320 plus 52 plus 14 is 386. That's why Arizal says he has a clinging to Mashiach. Rabbi Yosei Aglili, זכותו תגן אלינו. When you go to Israel, don't forget to visit. There's ציון, הוא תנה. יש לו אחיזה מחלק מהנשמה של דוד המלך. So, dear ladies, Rabbi Eliezer, we're going to the second תנה, Rabbi Eliezer. Can I wipe the board?
That is so amazing.
I can wipe? Okay, we're going to the second one. The second one, it says 40 plagues in Egypt and 200 plagues on the ocean. And this is the second name. So let's go to Rabbi Eliezer. Rabbi Eliezer. So let's look. Rabbi, we know it's 212. Eliezer. Aleph is 1, Lamed is 30, Yud is 10, Ayin is 70, Zayin is 7, and Reish is 200. How much is it together? 318. Together, how much is it? 530. Okay. 500. Taf is 400. Kuf equals 100. Lamed equals 30. Look, please, at the name of the second one that Arizal says. Taf, Kuf, Lamed. This is Rabbi Eliezer Atana. Zchuto tagen alenu. Look, it's the same name that Arizal says. The third one, we are speaking about the third one, and the third one is 50 plagues on Mitzrayim in Egypt, and then 250 plagues on the ocean. So, dear ladies, I'll write it over here. Rabbi Akiva. Rabbi is 212. Akiva, Ayin is 70. Kuf is 100. Yud is 10. Bet is 2. Aleph is 1. 183. Plus 212. It's 595. Shin equals 300. Tzadik equals 90, and Hey equals 5. This is the third name of the Tana, Rabbi Akiva. You see it over here? The letter Shin, the letter Tzadik, and the letter Hey. You see? Shin, Tzadik, Hey. Hashem said, the more that the Tanaim say that there were plagues in Egypt and the ocean, because Hashem promised us that He's not going to bring any sickness and all the plagues that He brought on Egypt upon us. So the Tanaim found through the Torah the number of plagues. So all of this cannot come on the children of Israel. You understand? Kol ha'marbe b'siyata d'shmaya moneh atzorot ma'am Yisrael. This is what happened. So we can see the third name, we see it over here. And then he says, with the thing that Hashem causes suffering, He also causes marpe, healing from the exile. Like we said in the beginning, already everything from the beginning, from the exile of Egypt that included all of the exiles until Mashiach, exile of Egypt. So, dear ladies, let's look at it. He says, "Vavemesha Kadosh Baruch Hu Makeh Bo Merape." With what Hashem gives suffering, with this He's going to heal the children of Israel. And we know that also from Yosef HaTzadik. Yosef HaTzadik was thrown to the pit because of his dreams. He caused jealousy to his brothers, and Hashem healed him with a dream. Pharaoh had a dream, and he solved the dream of Pharaoh and helped him. So with what Hashem gives suffering, with this He also heals. Dear ladies, inside the suffering is also already the solution. But the problem is that we listen to the evil inclination, we become depressed and sad, so we can't even find the livelihood that we need in order to heal ourselves. But Hashem in the suffering already has the healing. So once we keep a positive thinking and cling to Hashem, nothing can happen.
Amen.
Because we are already cured. So let's continue. So it says over here, Uma pashu bema chatu bema mahamal asher ma'alu avotenu. So what was their sin? What did they do that our forefathers had to go through this exile of Egypt? להיות בקור הברזל הזה עד שנגלו בשמות, until they were healed and redeemed by these names of angels over here. But where does this come from? So I'm going to wipe the board, okay? Okay, I want you to see this.
How is the healing inside the
family? You'll see. You'll see how it's important that we are called the children of Israel. So I'll write Israel over here. Okay? And please look. The plagues are the Tzach. You remember? The initials of the plagues, Adash. And then we have... Okay, the Tzach, Adash, Bachab. Okay? These are the plagues. Dear ladies, inside the plagues, there's already the healing, because the initials of these initials, Dalet, Ayin, Vebet, is the name of the first set of angels that helped the children of Israel. The second letters of the initials is the second name. You see, it's the second name. It's the first name is Dalet Ayin Bet. You see it over here, Dalet Ayin Bet. The second one is Tzadik, and the letter Dalet and the letter Aleph. Tzadik, Dalet, Ve'Aleph. The third one is all the other letters, the last letters. You see it over there? It's Chaf, there's the Chaf, the Shin, and here's the Shin, the Chet, here's the Chet, and the Bet, here's the Bet. With this Hashem redeemed the children of Israel from Egypt. And with this, Hashem is going to redeem all of us at this last exile. It's the same thing when Hashem brings only good things to the world. And everything comes with letters, with words. So if Hashem brings, dear ladies, if Hashem brings besiyata dishmaya to a person, retzeh, a will to do a good thing, Retzeh means will. But if this person sinned, these letters that come upon him become tzara. The letters change place inside the world and it's trouble, suffering. But Hashem brought this word to this world. Retzeh, goodwill. But then it became tzara because us, by our own choices, by the things that we do, not in the will of Hashem, the thing became, instead of a happiness, sadness. If Hashem brought oneg, oneg is pleasure. Hashem wants his daughter to have pleasure. But she sinned and she didn't do the right thing. Once it comes to this world, pleasure, it becomes nega, sickness. The same letters, just change places. So these letters of all the 10 plagues in a different combination become letters of healing. And all of this is Asher. It's in the name of the children of Israel. All of this is inside the name of the children of Israel. The plagues that will come on the nations, because at the end of days it will be just like it was in Egypt. And hail will come also on the nations. Everything that was in Egypt will come again. That's what Hashem said in the prophet Micha chapter 7. Verse 16. So dear ladies, kemetz etcham mitzayim arenu niflaot. We are standing now before Tisha B'Av. I would like to bless all of us that Hashem will give us the zchut to see all of the miracles, Bezrat Hashem. And because we're standing before Tisha B'Av, and Tisha B'Av is Tisha B'Av falls on Shabbat and it's postponed to Sunday, we're going to speak also about the halachot. But I would like to bless us and Klal Yisrael b'siyata d'shmaya. May Hashem b'siyata d'shmaya reveal Mashiach Tzidken b'mera b'yameinu amen. And may b'siyata d'shmaya Hashem will bring Eliyahu Navi Zachur L'Tov, and may we have the merit to see the third temple built achshav, now, Bezrat Hashem. And all of us will have the merit to go to the land of Israel at Kanpei Nesharim. Now we're going to go to through Shulchan Aruch. I would like to give you the halachot b'siyata d'shmaya. First of all, for the 9 days. Baruch, it's a big zchut to be in this shul.
Yes.
It's a big zchut to give the shul. Thank you, Hashem. Thank you, all the righteous tzaddikim. Ha'ari Zal Zchutot Hagen Elenu that wrote this, and the Rabbi Shimshon Mastropolia that explained this, the siyata d'shmaya. Now, dear ladies, let's go through the halachot. During the 9 days, we are not allowed to hear music. We are not allowed to say Shechianu. There's no weddings during the 9 days. And regarding Tisporet Begiluach, which means to cut the hair and to shave, dear ladies, during the 9 days, the Ashkenazi do not cut their hair or shave. Sephardic are allowed to cut their hair and shave. Sephardic do not cut the hair and shave only on the week that Tisha B'Av is.
Right.
But this year there's no week that Tisha B'Av is. It's postponed to Sunday. Regarding laundry, Ashkenazim these 9 days do not do laundry, but Sephardic do laundry during the 9 days. They do not do laundry only on the week that Tisha B'Av is. But this year we don't have, because Tisha B'Av is Shabbat. And regarding wine and meat, so Ashkenazi stopped drinking wine and wheat, except for Shabbat. From the first day of the month of Av, Sephardic started on the second day of the month of Av, because first day of the month of Av is Rosh Chodesh. Regarding dressing up with clothing that were already washed, already went through laundry, for Ashkenazi it's not allowed, so the solution is, before the 9 days, I hope they all dress everything. If it's underwear, dress it once, and then you can take it, not the whole day, but once to put it on yourself, then it's not considered that it went just out of the laundry. Or the Ben Ish Chai says you can put it on the floor and just walk, step on it, and this is also that is not considered that it's out of laundry. But Sephardic are allowed to do laundry and to wear those clothing these 9 days, except for the days that except for the days that the week that Tisha B'Av is in, and this year we don't have it. Rechitza letanug, to wash ourselves. Ashkenazi do not take a bath for pleasure, and a Sephardic can take a bath only except for the week that the ninth of Av is in, and this year we don't have it because the ninth of Av is on Shabbat. So, and Rabbi Ovadia Yosef says, if a person studies and he sweats because it's very warm, it's very hot outside, and you cannot study Torah if you don't feel that you are clean. So you are allowed to go and have a shower just with the cold water and not with the warm water. And regarding Kiddush Levana, the blessing for the Levana, the moon, so everybody does it after the end of Tisha B'Av, B'Siyata D'Shmaya. Furthermore, before Tisha B'Av, we have Suda Mafseket. We eat a meal before the fast. This fast is like Yom HaKippurim, the same thing like Yom HaKippurim. So, dear ladies, the meal before the fast, usually we eat two kinds of things, and it's supposed to be things that remind us that we are mourning the ruining of the temple. But this time, this year, Shabbat is Tisha B'Av. So Shalishit is the third meal on Shabbat after Mincha is Suda Mafseket. This is Suda Mafseket. And it says in Shulchan Aruch, Tisha B'Av, Shechal Be'echad B'Shabbat, or Shechal B'Shabbat Benitcha Le'echad B'Shabbat, which means that was postponed to Sunday, that the Tisha B'Av, the ninth of Av, is on Shabbat, and it is postponed to Sunday, the fast. Ochlin B'Shabbat Basar V'Shotin Yain. Dear ladies, kesudat ha-melech bishato, like the meal of King Solomon at that time. So dear ladies, you eat meat, you drink wine. Dear ladies, ואפילו בסעודה שלישית שלאחר מנחה מותר בכל, אך לא יישב אז בסעודת חברים. We don't sit with a lot of friends. We sit at home and we eat shalishidis, and this is סעודה מפסקת. And another thing, dear ladies, on the day of Tisha B'Av, we do not read Pirkei Avot, which means the people who read, because you remember we read Pirkei Avot from the Mishnah, between Pesach, after Pesach, the first Shabbat after Pesach until Shavuot, and then the Ashkenazi and other Sephardic people that read Pirkei Avot from after Shavuot until Rosh Hashanah. So on Shabbat, that 9th of Av is, we do not read Pirkei Avot. But you're allowed to read the portion of the week and also the Targum of Unculus, B'Siyata Dishmaya. What about the Avdalah, which is very important? So, regarding the Avdalah, Motzei Shabbat, we are blessing Mevarech Borei Maorei HaEsh. On Maorei HaEsh, dear ladies, we bless. But then, dear ladies, we say atachon antanu. Everybody that says arvit lemotzei shabbat says bechonen chokhma bina vadat says atachon antanu la'avdil ben kodesh lechol vechulei. But if you do not say arvit, you should say la'avdil ben kodesh lechol, la'avdil ben kodesh lechol, ben or lechoshech v'israel v'amim, without shem v'malchut, because we're having another havdalah after tisha b'av. So the two things that we do במוצאי שבת, at the end of Shabbat, one is lighting the candle, and the Be'orei Maorei HaEsh, and the second one, dear ladies, is the saying only by mouth, Ma'amavdil ben Kodesh Lechol, we say that without Shem ve'Malchut, because we say Shem ve'Malchut במוצאי תשעה באב. מוצאי תשעה באב, נשים יקרות, we then say, בסייעתא דשמיא, the blessing over the wine, and then we say with Shem v'Malchut, המבדיל בין קודש לחול. We do not say, dear ladies, we do not say מאורי האש, we don't bless over the candle, and we don't bless בלסמים, because בלסמים is for נשמה יתרה, it's only on Shabbat. So we don't bless over בלסמים, and we don't bless over the candle במוצאי תשעה באב, only over the wine, and המבדיל בין קודש לחול with Shem v'Malchut. Okay? So I would like to bless.
What about the
Tehillim
and Shurei
Torah? Okay, oh, very good. Dear ladies, you're allowed to listen to Shurei Torah on Tisha B'Av, but only the ones that are speaking about the ruining of the temple. Only things that are speaking. You're allowed to read Megillat Eicha. You're allowed to read Iyov. You are not allowed to read Tehillim. Only chapter Kuf Lamed Zayin, 137, Al Ne'arot Babel, Sham Yashavnu Gam Bachinu. The one that deals with the ruining
it's
of the
Shabbat.
Temple.
Yes,
this Shabbat after.
On Sunday.
Already after Tzoraim, you are not allowed to deal with anything.
What's
you
Shabbat?
Also read afternoon.
Of Shabbat?
Can.
Oh, after, as of 4 p.m., as of 5 p.m., as of
no, Sunday. After Besivot Echad. Besivot Echad. Kvar Besivot Echad, because it's Kvar Tisha B'Av. Besivot Echad, can. So you read in the morning the Tehillim, and Shum Bayah.
No, they said that until 12, 1 o'clock.
That's what I said, until, that's what I'm saying, until Ad Chatzot Hayom. Chatzot Hayom, the middle of the day is Be'erech, 10 minutes to 1. 12:50. So until 12:50 you can read Tehillim. After that you can read only Kuf Lamed Zayin, 137. No, dear ladies,
until 10 to 1.
Ken, this is in the morning we say. Everything in the morning until the middle of the day. And the Tehillim that you can read is 137 that says Al Na'arot Babel Sham Yashavnu Gam Bachinu. Now you're allowed to listen to Shurei Torah. Only the ones that are Shurei Torah over the ruining of the temple. So you can listen to this. You can read Megillat Eicha. You can read Iyov. You can read also the Prophet Yirmiyahu, only the chapters that deal with the prophecies that speak about the ruining of the temple. So this is a good opportunity also to study the book of Iyov, which is not easy to study it. So, dear ladies, I would like to wish all of us that this will be the last fast of Tisha B'Av. That Bezat Hashem, the 17th of Tammuz and the 9th of Av will become high holidays, and all the 3 weeks will become Chol HaMoed. And may Hashem b'siyata nishmeh bring Mashiach tzidkenu b'biram yamenu amen. May Hashem bring the mevaser el yarnu v'zachur l'tov, v'lola miparad adam mechabur b'dvar halacha yachid berabim halacha kerabim. Hashem bless you. Chazak, next week on...